several labs on campus do research related to uranium. Our first story features an undergraduate who works here in the Wetaw building in the laboratory of Dr. Diane Stearns. Mary Zuniga is a junior in biology with a minor in chemistry. She is examining the ways depleted uranium can damage skin cells.
We're also combining this study with UV light. So we are looking at the interaction of depleted uranium and UV light and how they interact together to cause DNA damage in cells.
While uranium has been linked to several types of cancer, the effects of exposure on the skin is a unique area of research. Keratinocyte, a type of skin cell, is grown in the lab to form a layer of skin for testing.
When we have that layer, we dose it with depleted uranium, and then we look at how much damage depleted uranium has caused in those cells.
By understanding the effects of uranium on the body's largest organ, systems could be developed to protect people who become exposed. Here in Stearns' lab, scientists, including undergraduates like Zuniga, are studying how metals cause cancer. There is still a lot to discover about uranium and how it acts as a heavy metal or a chemical.
Uranium has chemical properties. It will interact with DNA. It will cause mutations that have nothing to do with its radioactivity. So we think that there's still a lot to learn about what it's doing as a heavy metal so that we can understand what the risks are.
In addition to researching uranium, Dr. Stearns says she enjoys mentoring students, especially undergraduates like Zuniga who are self-motivated.
I think one of the best things about NAU is the opportunities that students have to do real research. It's not carried out by postdocs where you get to come in and wash glassware. And my students are actually doing the experiments and getting their names on the publications.
After a summer fellowship at Johns Hopkins, Mary Zuniga was named as a second author on a paper, a relatively rare accomplishment for an undergraduate. Her accomplishments and work in this lab will likely serve her well as she pursues an MD, PhD in the molecular field, focusing on oncology.